In this tutorial, we will take a quick look at LED panels. As you will surely know by now, there are multiple ways in which you can use displays, etc. If you go to the library, you will notice that we have a dedicated LED panel library as well. Let's just grab this model, a CB5 with a pixel pitch around 5 mm. We can now drag and drop it into our screen's workspace. If you click on the panel, you will see the LED panel's properties in the inspector window on the right-hand side, which includes the canvas resolution, the size, its position, as well as the physical resolution a bit further down below, where you can also find out about pixel count and the pixel pitch. What may also be of interest to you might be the weight and the power consumption, which can definitely be important to know, especially during the planning phase. It's pretty easy to create an array using the inspector. Let's say you know you have an LED display that consists of 5 horizontal and 2 vertical panels. Then you can simply enter those values and create an array just like that in your workspace. PIXERA will automatically show you the right canvas resolution and the complete resolution as well. And again, you can also easily check the newly calculated weight and power consumption. Of course, you can also give a name to your LED panel. In our case, let's be very creative and let's call it LED panel. You can also choose a different color for your LED panel. It is also possible to display the values per square meter, in case you want to know what your resolution per square meter is. Of course, you can also use a generic LED panel and not one already in the manufacturer library. Just drag and drop a generic panel into your workspace. You can then continue to define the size. Let's go with a 0.2 meter width and a height of 0.4 meter. Let's go for a 0.05 depth, meaning 5 centimeters. You can also create a panel array using your generic panel. Let's go for 5 horizontally. And as expected, all the changed values get updated instantly. The LED panels act in much the same way as, for example, displays. You can, of course, allocate an output to your panel. You do this by going to Mapping and by then selecting Screens in the Selection mode. You then select the panel, click on the output with a right click, assign to output, and this way the LED panel has been assigned or allocated to an output of your choice.